Egyébként a szénnám a kivarítszá van. Ambalás szalti forward, softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling. Jesus is calling, calling for you and for me. To meditate on verse 2 as we sing it softly. Why should we tarry when Jesus is calling, waiting for you and why should we linger and heed not his mercy? Because of grace, there's mercy enough for you and me. He's saying today, come home. Come home. Come home.
This place that we have dedicated to worship you and you alone, we are thankful that you are God and beside you there is no other. You created this world out of nothing. You formed man out of the dust of the ground and breathed into our nostrils the breath of life, and we became living souls. For this too, we said thank you, God, for being our creator. And when we sin, dear Lord, we were not an afterthought, for you knew that the day would come and you immediately sprung into action the plan of salvation, that your dear son would come. Live among us, show us how to depend on the Father. Die a death that was not his, that we may receive eternal life that we did not deserve. But because of grace and mercy, you have saved us, and you have saved us eternally. So help us, the Lord, to lean on the everlasting arm, depending not on our own strength or ideas, but that we will totally depend on Jesus Christ. As we look at 48 years of independence for our Bahama land, we thank you, the Lord, for from whence you have brought us in the midst, the Lord, of, from one crisis to another. You have sustained us as a nation, as a people, and as individuals. Call us into an everlasting covenant where we can depend on you, dear Lord, not just for time, but also, Lord, for eternity. You desire to save us, Heavenly Father. So I pray today that as we think about the word that you are softly calling us, dear Lord, that we will surrender our heart afresh and anew to you today, saying, I yield to your will and to your way. Help us, dear Lord, that we would be willing and obedient because you have promised us that you have gone to prepare a place for us. Help us, dear Lord, because of a faith relationship with you, that we would indeed be able to look up one day and say, this is our God for whom we have waited, for whom we have prayed, for whom we have tarried. He has now come to save us, and we will go home with him. Heavenly Father, we bring before you today your manservants, who you have called for such a time as this, to rightly divide the word of truth. I pray, Heavenly Father, that you would hide him behind the cross of Calvary. You would anoint him, his head from on high, down to the very soles of his feet. You would loosen his stumbling tongue, the Heavenly Father, and put words on his lips, the Lord, that as he speaks, Heavenly Father, Jesus Christ may be seen high and lifted up, and that we would give glory to his name. Let the words that he speaks, Heavenly Father, be true, the Lord, coming straight from your Holy Spirit, and may it touch our hearts. May it cause us, dear Lord, to be uncomfortable in our seats. May it cause us to cry in our hearts, Lord, save me, for I cannot save myself. Today, Heavenly Father, do that work, dear Lord, of saving us in spite of ourselves, in spite of our waywardness, in spite, dear Lord, of the many times that we have turned our back on you. We cry out yet again, dear Lord, save me lest I perish. Lord, let our cry today be, I cannot save myself. I turn it over now to Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. So may Heavenly Father, as he stand up to preach, may we hear you speaking to him, the Lord. May we surrender our heart again. And may when we leave this place, may we go out into the highways and byways to call men and women out of darkness and saying, come see a man who told me all. Is not this the Christ? May we indeed, the Lord, lead this place today as we embark on a new and untried week with Jesus in our heart, with the Holy Spirit going before us to seek and to save the Lord at any cost. And let your people, the Lord, may they truly be grateful, the Lord, for your Holy Spirit today, who have spoken to us, who have touched our hearts, and who will transform our life. But once again, Holy Father, be with your manservant. Be with the message, and indeed be with your people. And may we be blessed today and your name glorified. We ask all this in no other name but the name of Jesus Christ, who saved us. Amen. Who are weary, come home.